Hello everyone, myself Anuradha, research scholar from the Department of Chemistry, University of Jammu. Here I am present a part of my research work, and the topic of my presentation is the role of non-covalent interactions in enhancing the stability of the tetraphenyl arsenium dithiophosphate salts. First of all, a brief introduction about the non-covalent interactions. Non-covalent interactions differ from a covalent bond in that it does not involve the sharing of electrons, but rather involves more dispersed variation of electrostatic interactions between molecules or within a molecule. These non-covalent interactions play an important role in supramolecular chemistry and crystal design. Solid-state crystal structures are stabilized through various non-covalent interactions such as hydrogen bonding pi pi extra. Weak interactions such as CHX, CH pi, pi pi, where X represents oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, chlorine, chlorine extra, are of significant concern in determining the stability of the complexes. Now, this slide presents the molecular structure of our tetraphenyl arsenium dithiophosphate salts. Both the two salts consist of the same structure, cationic and anionic part. In both the structure, the cationic part consists of the tetraphenyl arsenium moiety having the arsenic atom attached to the four phenyl rings, whereas the anionic part consists of the dithiophosphate moiety in which the phosphorus atom is attached to two sulfur and two oxygen atoms. The two molecular structures are similar in all aspects rather than in the position of the substituent group, which in case of complex A, the two methyl groups are attached at the position 2 and 4, whereas in complex B, the two methyl groups are attached at the position 3 and 5. The next slide presents the various non-covalent interactions that are present in the salt 1. Here, the figure A represents the CHO interactions present in the salt 1. The two monomer units of the salt 1 are interconnected to each other through the two CHO interactions, which are C10H10O1 and C39H39BO2, resulting in the formation of a network-like structure. The various monomer moieties, when connected through these CHO interactions, result in the formation of a network-like structure, which when viewed along the B axis shows the pattern as represented in the figure B. This slide represents the CHS interaction present in the salt A, and when the various monomer moieties are interlinked to each other through this CHS interaction, a network-like structure similar to that as represented in the network-like structure as represented in the figure A was formed. And here the figure B represents the CH pi interaction, where the centroid of the phenyl ring, as represented by the centroid of the phenyl ring, interacts with the hydrogen H39A of the anionic moiety. All these interactions result in the extension of the molecular structure of the salt, which further enhancing the stability of the complexes. Now this slide represents the non-covalent interaction in salt 2. Here, the two monomer moieties are connected to each other through the CHO interaction, which are C40H40CO2 and C3H3O2, resulting in the formation of a cyclic ring-like structure as shown in the figure. Here, this slide presents the CHS interactions present in the molecule. The molecules are interlinked to each other through three types of CH interaction, which are C5H5S2, C12H12S2 and C22H22S1. However, and when the various monomer moieties are interlinked through these CHS interactions, a network-like structure as represented in the figure is formed. Now, this slide represents the CH pi interaction in salt 2, where the centroid of the phenyl ring interacts with the hydrogen of the tetraphenyl arsenium moiety. This side now comes to the Hirschfeld surface analysis of the molecule. Hirschfeld surface analysis is a quantitative way to determine the various non-covalent interactions present in our molecules. Hirschfeld surface analysis was performed on the SIF files of the crystal structure using Crystal Explorer 17.5 software. Graphical plots of the Hirschfeld surface with denom used a red blue white color scheme, where the red color indicates the region of short contacts and the white color indicates the contacts which are in the range of the van der Waals contacts, and the blue color indicates the longer contacts. And here in the figure, the various red color spots that are formed on the Hirschfeld in surface indicates the various interactions which are HH, CH, OH, SH present in the molecule. The middle, in the other two diagrams, the presence of a red color region over the phenyl rings indicates the presence of the CH pi interaction of the molecule. This slide represents the fingerprint plots of the salts 1 and 2, which is also part of the Hirschfeld surface analysis. This fingerprint plots gives us the percentage contribution made by the various non-covalent interactions towards the total Hirschfeld surface. And from the fingerprint plots of the two salts, we come to the conclusion that the major non-covalent interaction present in both the molecule is the HH, which contributes to about 57.1% in case of salt 1 and 55.3% in case of salt 2. And the HH interaction in the molecule is represented by spike-like in the structure. And the least contribution in both the salts is made by the OH-HO interaction, which contributes to about 1.4% in case of salt 1 and 3.8% in case of salt 2. This Hirschfeld surface analysis is an experimental gives us a quantitative way to study the non-covalent interactions present in the molecules. Then come to the computational analysis of the salts. Here the computational analysis is completely a theoretical study based on the electron density, which is used to determine the stability of the salts. Here we represent the homo-lumo energy gap diagram of the two salts. And where homo represents the highest occupied molecular orbital and lumo represents the lower occupied molecular orbital. And in both the salts, we can see that in case of homo, the major electron density is present over the dithiophosphate anionic moiety. And in case of lumo, the major electron density is present over the tetraphenyl arsenium moiety. An energy gap of 2.53 electron volt and 2.68 electron volt in case of both the salts indicates the polarizable nature of both the salts and further the chemical soft nature of both the salts. Then comes to the molecular electrostatic potential diagram, which can also be determined using the computational analysis. This is a color diagram which is used to determine the site for the various nucleophilic and electrophilic attacks in the molecule. Here the red color indicates the region of a higher electron density and thus the site where an electrophile can attack, and the blue region indicates the region of the lower electron density and hence the region for the nucleophilic attack. Conclusion: in this presentation we have reported three tetraphenyl arsenium complexes corresponding to the formula PH4 arsenic S2PO2, where AR and the single crystal reveals that the complexes are stabilized by various non-covalent interactions, which are CHX, CH pi. These non-covalent interactions in the molecules result in their extension along different crystallographic axes. Then Hirschfeld surface analysis has been carried out in order to check the fidelity of the various non-covalent interactions in the molecules that are reported by using the single crystal X-ray analysis. Finally, the homo-lumo energy gap of the molecules calculated using theoretical computational analysis helps in determining the stability index of the molecules. Thanks.